The command or the control key might seem pretty insignificant, but today I'm going to show you various different ways in which you can improve your workflow and help your overall usage of Adobe Illustrator. Sponsoring today's video is Template Monster, which is the best and the biggest collection of website templates online. However, later in the video, I'm going to show you their free courses with things like HTML, WordPress, Shopify, and so much more. There's also a discount code hidden within the last lesson, but more about that later in today's video. So as I mentioned, today we're focusing on the command key when using a Mac, or the control key when using a PC, and you're guaranteed to learn at least one thing today. So the first method is to quickly switch between the selection tools. So by default, have the standard selection tool in use, aka the black arrow tool, and then you can hold down the command or the control key, which will then bring into use the direct selection tool. Now this is a nifty time saver in your workflow. Say for example here, I want to move around the shape easily with the selection tool. I can then hold down the command or the control key to allow me to manipulate the anchor points and also the handles wherever I want to or need to in my workflow. Also, for those of you who use Illustrator CC, you can then use this method to edit the live corners pretty quickly. So yeah, the first technique basically shifts between the selection tools in real quick time. The second use of the command or the control key in Adobe Illustrator is based around using the pen tool. So firstly, when creating a pen tool path, we might want to select off of the path, and that requires us to come over to the selection tool in the toolbar. This is annoying and it's also time consuming, which is going to strain your workflow. So instead, just hold down the command or the control key and then click the artboard once. This will select off of the pen tool path and it's very quick. The second part to this tip is that you can also use this function to click and edit your pen tool path's anchor points. You can do this while having the pen tool still in use, and again, this is a great time saver and an addition to your workflow that you probably should include. For the third example, when using the command or the control key, we're actually focusing on text. Now I'm sure that you do find it annoying that when you have the type tool in use, you cannot move the text without heading over to the selection tool. So instead, just hold down the command or the control key, and then you can move the text around. Not only that, but you can also even adjust the size of the text if you hold down shift at the same time. Now this is one of my favorite uses of the command or the control key. But moving on to the fourth addition in today's video, a quick and a simple technique for you to see. If you're using the kind of mouse that has the toggle wheel, you can move your view frame up and down by scrolling the wheel. However, if you do the same thing but while holding down the command or the control key, you can actually toggle your viewpoint from left to right. This is something to keep in mind for your workflow in Adobe Illustrator. The last use of the command or the control key is another way to save time, but in this instance, it's going to be when using the eyedropper tool. We can keep the tool in use effectively, but we can actually move around objects while holding down the command or the control key, and then release it to return back to the eyedropper tool, so we can then sample some more colors within our graphic designs. Now I do use this one quite often in my workflow, so it is good to remember. Today's video was made with my new microphone, so do let me know how the sound quality is for you while listening to the video. Also, let me know which of these five techniques you found most useful, and also if you've learned something today. You can learn many handy techniques for website design with Template Monster. They've introduced a whole array of absolutely free courses on their website. There are quite a few categories to choose from, as you can see on screen right now, and there is quite a lot of choice open to you for free. All you need to do is to check the box of the free course that you want to view, and then type in your email address. The course will be sent to your email within seconds. And also, if you do get through to the last class of the courses, you're going to be awarded a discount code to any product on Template Monster's website. So there's quite the incentive to check out their free courses via the link down below. If you want to keep boosting your graphic design skills and your awareness as a designer, subscribe to my channel for weekly graphic design content. Have a great day, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.